Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In today's video, we're gonna explore some really cool AI photo editing tools from Fotor. If you want to speed up your editing without losing quality, these tools will be super helpful. We'll cover a bunch of AI tools like enhancing photos, removing unwanted objects, changing backgrounds, and even creating artworks. Whether you are a photographer, a content creator, or just someone who loves editing, these features will make things much faster and easier. So let's get started. Fotor has a lot of great AI tools that makes photo editing simple and quick, and here's what we'll cover in this tutorial. First, we'll cover AI Photo Enhancer, then we'll talk about AI Skin Retouch, then AI Object Remover or Text Remover, then we'll talk about AI Background Remover, AI Replacement, AI Expand, and lastly AI Art Generator. So let's go through each tools and see how they work. First, we'll talk about AI Photo Enhancer. This tool is perfect if you want to quickly improve the overall quality of your photo. It automatically adjusts the things like brightness, contrast, sharpness, and saturation to give your image a polished and professional look. For example, here's a photo that looks a bit dull. What I'll do is I'll first select the image and I'll click on AI Photo Enhancer, and within a second, you can see how it sharpens the detail and add more vibrancy to the image. It's perfect for making your photos pop, whether they are for social media, blogs, or professional portfolios. To smoothen the skin, to remove all those pimples and all, we'll just click on AI Skin Retouch. So click on AI Skin Retouch, just click, and within a second, it will clear up the skin. If you compare, you can see this is the original image and this is the image after editing, and you can see the skin is much more clearer. But if you want to do more adjustments with this, we got further adjustments. We can go to adjustment here, and here you got some settings. Here you can adjust the crop, resize, fine tune, and if you want to do adjustment with the skin, you can go to beauty, and here you can smoothen your skin, you can add blush, and you can draw eyeshadow, eyeliner. There are lots of settings, but here what I want is I want to remove those blemishes on the skin. So to remove that, I'm going to use the blemish mix. So click on it, and here you got a size adjustment, adjust the size of the brush. So just click on the skin, and this will remove those marks from the skin. So I'm just go around the edges, and I'll just remove these dark patches from the skin. Click. So I'll go down here, you can see there are lots of patches over here, so I'll just go there and just click on it to clear up the skin. So once you have fixed the skin, you can just go and click on apply. And after that, let's smoothen the skin. So for that, I'll go to smoothing option here. Just click on it, and here you got this brush size, and you can set the intensity over here. So adjust the intensity and the brush size. Let's reduce the brush size around this much and just paint over the skin. As you can see, it's making the skin smoother. Make it smaller just to paint around the eyes area. So just go there and paint it around the eyes. And as you can see, if you click on this compare button, you can see that this is the original image and this is the image after editing, and it looks amazing. You can see the using the AI Skin Retouch and AI enhancement, it has given that nice cool effect. And using these beauty tools where you got these attributes, blemish fix and smoothing, using that, you have given that nice smooth effect to your skin. And after that, you can go around with all these options here. You can just go to the eye tint right here, and under here you can choose a color which you want, and let's choose the blue color. And over here, just adjust the size and just click over there, and just to give that bluish tint to your eyes. Do it for the other eyes as well, and there we go. Next we have AI Object Remover. This is another fantastic tool. If you have something in your photo that you don't want, like an unwanted object or a text, this tool will remove it for you. Here's an example. Just open your image and we'll click on magic eraser tool, right? And it's very easy. You can use the brush tool or quick selection. So with the brush tool, adjust the size and just select it. So you want to remove this specs, just select that and just click on remove. And there we go, it's removed. You can just apply again, brush around there and just click removing. And there we go, we have removed that. Over here, I've got some images over here. So if you see if there are signboards, so you want to remove these signs, you can just click on magic eraser tool and set your brush size okay around this much, and just click and drag and just there, and click on remove, and it will be removed from your image. Very simple, very easy, right there. You want to remove this, just select that, okay again, and just click on remove. Very simple. Now if you want to remove the text, you can click on quick selection okay, and this will read the image and make a selection of the surfaces. So I'll just zoom it in and we'll select these, okay, these individuals. Or maybe just go to brush and just paint over here, right? And paint on this text. And after that, click on remove. There we go. Next, we have the AI background remover tool. If you need to isolate your subject, the AI background remover is a great tool. With just one click, it identifies the subject and removes the background, leaving you with a clean and professional result. Here's an example. So I got this image here. To remove this background, you just have to use the BG remover. Just click on it and it will automatically read the image and remove your background. There we go. We got that image, PNG image where the background has been removed, and you can just click on apply and there we go. We got that nice PNG image. You can just click on download. You can download it in JPEG or PNG, and here you can set the definition of your image, high resolution, and you can click on download and your image will be downloaded. So here we got an image where we got a shoe and there is a blanket on the background. Suppose you want to remove this background. So it's very simple. Just click on BG remover, right? And it will automatically read the background and remove it. And if you want to change the background, you can just click on change background. Suppose you want to add a color in the background, you can just choose colors from here, right? Very easy. Or if you want to give some images, you can choose from here photos, and you can choose from any of the photos from here just to give that cool look to your image. And after that, once you're happy with this, you can just click on download and your image will be downloaded. And within a moment, it's ready to use in a catalog or an e-commerce store. Very easy. Next, we have AI replace tool. You can replace parts of your image with new elements, like changing the sky or adding an object. For example, I got this image over here and you can see there is an ice cream cone. And if you want to replace this ice cream with a flower, find the AI replace option. You just go down here, right? And you see this AI replace option. Just click on it and you got this option, brush and quick select. You can click on quick select and it will read your image and select each of the elements easily. Let's see over here. So you can see our ice cream has been selected and the background is on different layer, right? But what we need is we don't want this selection. So I'll just go to brush and I'll just paint out this area. So I'll just make it bigger and just paint around this. Okay, something like this. Okay, and I'll just type over here a bunch of flowers. Let's say white flowers. Let's click on generate. And there we go. It looks great, right? Our ice cream has been replaced by a flower and we got two options. So we got this first one and the second one, and I think the first one looks great. And if you feel like these two are not good enough, you can just click on generate more and it will generate more other options and it will be done. And once you're happy with that, I can just click on apply and there we go. We have replaced our image. In the same way, we can look at our second image over here. You can see it's holding some kind of herbs and all. Let's replace it with a coin. So what I'll do is I'll use the brush again and just paint over it. Just make sure you're painting on these only because I want to make sure our hands are nicely maintained. There we go. And here I'll type bunch of coins and let's see what it generates. And here it is. Our herbs has been replaced by coins and we got two options, one over here and let's see the other one. And there we go. I think both of them looks good. You can choose any of them and let's apply it. And there we go. We have replaced our image. So this option can be used anywhere. You can replace your sky, any props you don't like, caps, dress, everything that you don't like on your image, and it will be replaced with a single click. Next, we have AI expand tool. You can extend your image boundaries creatively. This is especially useful when you need a larger composition or want to add extra space at your edges, perfect for creating wider images. Suppose we have this image and you feel like you want to increase the background area. So what I'll do is I'll use the AI expand tool, right? Click on it and there it is. You can increase or decrease this area. So you can just make it a little bit larger or you can expand more area. So I'll keep it around this much. And let's say I think this is good. You can move the photos here and there and I'll keep it around here. And I'll click on generate and let's see. And there we go. We got a nice background extended. You got two options over here. One is over here and the other one is this. And I think this is looking better. I'll choose this one. And if you zoom it in, it looks amazing. If you want to see our original image, you can just click on here and compare it. This is our original image. And this is the image using the AI expand option created. And it looks good. We got that nice realistic background, trees, leaves, skies, and it looks good. Let's check out on the other image. I got this image over here. You can see we got this frame and the wall area is a little bit narrow. So I want to expand it. What I can do is I can use the AI expand again. You just go over here, right? And click on AI expand. So I'll go to AI expand And there we go. Here you can adjust the size. So I'll just increase it to around this much and click on generate. And there it is. Our frame has been placed in a nicely room and it's a wall. You can just check out other option as well. This also looks good. Both of the images looks great. And I feel this is better because it looks very natural because it's placed on the wall and it's a side of a wall. And you can even generate more. And if you don't like this image, you can just click on cancel and it will get back to your original image. And here you can even customize your size. You can just go to size, right? Here you can adjust your customize your size. You can go over here and increase the height or decrease the like sideways. So with this tool, it fills in the extra space beautifully, making everything consistent. So this is the AI expand option. Finally, we have the AI art generator. And this tool is a very fun tool that turns your photos into artwork like sketches, paintings or digital work. I'll take a simple photo and use the AI art generator to turn it into a beautiful painting. So we got to see this AI art generator, just click on it, there we go. And with this AI art generator, you can create a bunch of effects like pencil drawing, Picasso style. So let's apply it to our image. So I'll just go over here and choose any image. Let's say you choose this image, I'll just click OK and there it is, our image. Now you want to create a like sketch effect. So we got some effects over here. So you can choose the sketch too, or you got a bundle of sketch effects over here on down, there it is. Pencil sketch, we got ink art, sketch 2. So I'll just click on this sketch 2 and just apply it. And there we go. You can just compare it. This is our image and this is the sketch we have created. You can adjust the intensity over here. You can just make it a little bit around this much. This also looks good, or you can keep it 100% sketch. So I'll just keep it around this much, leaving a certain color tone, and it looks amazing. In the same way, I can choose any other like comic art. Let's say vintage comic. Just click on it. There it is. This is our original image and this is the comic effect, vintage comic effect, and it looks good. Let's apply on different images as well. Let's use this. Okay, this is the image and let's give some different art effect here. So let's see what arts we can apply. We got the structuralism effect. Let's try to apply it. And here it is. I can just adjust the intensity over here, lower to around this much, and it looks good. We got lots of other options. You can just try it out. Growing sunset, let's apply that and let's see what it looks. And there it is. Let's compare it. Original image and effect after applying the effect, the image. And I think this looks good. Lastly, let's look at how we can use all these effects all together. So let's say I got an image. So let's open the image. I'll go to AI tool, right? If you first open your footer here, you can see we got this interface, right? And under interface, you got these options like image generator, photo editor, AI, image generator, AI filters and effects, quick design. I'll go to AI tools and here you can see we got image generator where you got these options, and this is the tools which we're going to use for editing tools. We got these, all these options here. You can see background remover, AI upscaler, a magic eraser, enhancer. You can like sharpen your unblurred photos. You can replace images, expand images. With just one click, you can retouch your skin. You can colorize your old images. You can like change the background and even blur out the background. On the bottom, we have AI effects where you can transform your images to any kind of effects. And lastly, we have the AI video generator. Let's go to AI enhancer, right? Click over there and let's bring in an image. So I'll just open my image. I'll bring this image. Okay. And here's our image. And let's say I want to enhance this. So I'll just click on enhance, right? And our image is enhanced. You can just check out the image. This is our original image and this is the image after applying the effect. Let's say you want to remove the background. Just click on BG remover and it will automatically remove the background. Click apply. And after that, let's say you want to add a background. So I'll go to BG remover, right? And change the background over here and add a color, right? Simple color, gray, or maybe some color brown. Or you can go to photos and pick some colors, interesting colors. And I think this looks good. And there it is. Suppose you want to change the hair. So I'll just paint over here. Okay, around the head. Just type in brown hair and click on generate. So we got two options, one here and the other one here. I will just take this one and apply it. Okay, and we have replaced the hair. Next, let's say you want to add a text. You can just click on text and choose from the collection of text from here. Let's choose this one and there it is. I'll just replace this with AI tools and place it there. This one, photo. And there we go. We got that nice text. So over here, you can change the fonts. We got a collection of fonts over here. You can just choose any of it. Let's say this one, or if you don't like it, you can just undo it. Click over here and just undo, or Command or Control Z. And there it is. Here, you can change the colors. You can apply it to different colors you want. Let's say blue. And this one, you can change this color to anything that suits your design. These features are perfect for everyone who want to make their photo editing faster, easier, and more professional. And that's a quick look at some of the Fotor's amazing AI tools. These tools are perfect for making your photo editing faster and easier without compromising on quality. If you're interested to try this out by yourself, I'll leave a link to Fotor's website in the description below. Also, let me know in the comment section which AI tool you found most useful. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.